morning and welcome to the Morning Expresso by the Indian Express. My name is Rahil Philippos and here is today's big story. Amid the flurry of resignations from the BJP in Uttar Pradesh, a minister and two more MLAs resigned on Thursday, saying that the party had done very little for marginalized communities in the last 5 years. Dharam Singh Saini, Minister for Ayush and MLA from Nagpur constituency in Saharanpur, Mukesh Verma, MLA from Shikohabad in Firozabad, and Avasthi Bala Prasad, MLA from Daurara in Lakhimpur, were the three BJP MLAs who resigned. Meanwhile, having centered the Congress's campaign around women empowerment in the run-up to the UP elections, Congress General Secretary Priyanka Gandhi Vadra announced the names of 50 women in the party's first list of 125 candidates. Among the women was the mother of the Unnao rape survivor, an ASHA worker who was roughed up by police, a former SP leader who was attacked during the Panchayat elections, and a social activist and Congress leader who was arrested during the anti-CAA protests. Next up are our stories exclusive to the Indian Express. Delhi University Professor Satish Deshpande explains how hate crimes in India have been cultivating for over a century now. You can read his opinion on theindianexpress.com. And now for our stories from the front page. In Dhumka district, an audit of 869 work sites found 774 people at work, although 7,712 were listed on the rolls. In Dhanbad, 7,859 people were on the rolls for 1,348 schemes that were audited, but only 421 people were actually on site. These are the key discrepancies found by the social audit carried out by Jharkhand's Rural Development Department in its latest concurrent audit of work under MGNREGA. The Indian Express has accessed the report to track down illustrative examples of irregularity. It's being called the Diamond Harbour model. In West Bengal, which is currently grappling with a massive COVID surge, high positivity rates, low testing, and a Kumbh-scale Ganga Sagar Mela for which pilgrims started arriving on Wednesday, this Kolkata suburb certainly stands out. It stands out for its country-wide record in daily testing for any constituency on January 12th, for low positivity and for banning any gatherings. Next up are our must-read stories. 74 years after the border split the two Punjabs, leaving Sikha Khan on one side and his elder brother Sadiq in the Pakistani part, never to be together again, all it took for the search to end was a video shared on social media. Now a frail man in his 70s, Sikha was finally reunited with his elder brother at Kartarpur Gurudwara on Monday. Now every day of being apart is tough. From organizing massive women's-only marathons to doling out freebies. In Uttar Pradesh, a state where caste and religion usually blur all other considerations during polls, this season political parties are tripping over one another to get women voters behind them. Among the reasons for this are a rise in the number of women voters, polling percentages, as well as several social changes. The Environment Ministry's latest India State of Forests report showed a continuing increase in forest cover across the country, but experts flagged some of its other aspects as potential causes for concern. These include a decline in forest cover in the northeast as well as a degradation of natural forests. We break down some of the findings of this report. The son of former Defence Minister and three-time Goa Chief Minister Manohar Parrikar has staked his claim to a BJP ticket for the elections from Goa's capital Panaji, the constituency from where his late father was elected 5 times since 1995. For the ruling BJP, conceding Utpal's demand will be a tough call given the claims of other formidable party aspirants for the Panaji seat. BJP's Goa in charge, Devendra Fadnavis, said the BJP does not give election tickets to candidates just because they are party leaders' children. And finally, the stakes are high for young Indian cricketers who are embarking on the Under-19 World Cup campaign, with the IPL auction slated to take place just days after the final in February. How do these teens handle the pressure of quick fame and potentially big money? The newly appointed Punjab captain Abhishek Sharma recalls a piece of advice offered by Rahul Dravid. He told them to decide what is more important to them, playing for India at present or the IPL. And that's all for today's Morning Expresso. Thank you for watching and don't forget to subscribe to the Indian Express's YouTube channel for the latest news updates.